Welcome to Big Easy Life. It is August 1st, 2020, and it's time for Today in Big Easy History. On this date in 1952, at exactly 8 p.m., a New Orleans landmark was lit for the first time, the Falstaff Brewing Company Light. Located at 2601 Gravier Street, they installed a 126-foot tower with an electrical sign on top of their new brewery. The sign went dark on December 7, 1978. On that day, the facility was closed, at first temporarily, then permanently. The sign was dark for many years until the brewery sign was renovated and the brewery was converted into condominiums. It is August 2nd, 2020. On this date in 1967, New Orleans Saints played their first ever game. They lost to the Los Angeles Rams 16-7 at Anaheim Stadium. In this, the Saints' first preseason game. The Saints' 1967 preseason record was 5-1. August 3rd, on this day in 1975, the Superdome held its official dedication ceremony. Jazz musicians Al Hurt and Pete Fountain played for the event. On this same day, Tulane Stadium was officially condemned. It is August 4th. On this date in 1939, Frankie Ford was born. He was an American rock and roll and rhythm and blues singer. He was born in Gretna, Louisiana. Ford had a top 20 hit in 1959 with Sea Cruise. The record sold over 1 million copies, gaining gold disc status. On May 16, 2010, at the Louisiana Music Homecoming in Irwinville, Ford was inducted into the Louisiana Music Hall of Fame. It is August 5th. On this date in 1978, the NFL played the first game ever in Mexico City. The New Orleans Saints beat the Philadelphia Eagles by a score of 14-7. It is August 6th. On this date in 1862, during the Union occupation of New Orleans, during the Civil War, Jonas H. French was appointed mayor of the city on this day and served until August 20th of that same year. It is August 7th, 2020. On this date in 1727, the Company of the West, founded to administrate the Louisiana Territory, through a Jesuit priest in New Orleans, persuaded the Ursulines of Rouen, France, to establish a convent in Louisiana, with a dual objective: to educate the young and to care for the sick. The Ursulines graciously accepted the challenge, arriving on this day after a five-month journey. It is August 8th. On this date in 1960, Fats Domino's Walkin' to New Orleans broke into Billboard's top 10 list. The song went on to sell over 2 million copies. The record was a hit released on Imperial Records, reaching number 6 on the pop chart and number 2 on the R&B chart. It is August 9th. On this date in 1956, Elvis Presley performed on stage from 7:30 to 10:30 p.m. at Pontchartrain Beach, the amusement park at the end of Elysian Fields. It is August 10th. On this date in 1755, the expulsion of the Acadians, also known as the Great Upheaval, the Great Expulsion, and Le Grand Derangement, was the forced removal by the British of the Acadian people from present-day Canadian maritime provinces of Nova Scotia, New Brunswick, and Prince Edward Island. They were also moved from parts of the U.S. states such as Maine. This whole area was known as Acadia. The first wave of the expulsion began on this day from the Bay of Fundy. It is August 11th. On this day in 1996, the Big Easy television series, inspired by the film of the same name from 1987, premiered on the USA cable network. 35 episodes were broadcast over 2 seasons. The series takes place in New Orleans, Louisiana, and was shot on location. It is August 12th. On this date in 1926, singer, songwriter, and arranger Joe Jones was born in New Orleans. Jones is also generally credited with discovering the Dixie Cups, and he worked with B.B. King as a singer. Jones' greatest hit was the top 5 1960 R&B hit, You Talk Too Much, which also reached number 3 on the pop chart. It is August 13th. On this date in 1795, the members of the Cabildo were convened in extraordinary session by the governor, Carondelet, to discuss means for repairing the levee and meat market, which was damaged by the river during a hurricane on the night of the 10th. It is August 14th. On this date in 1988, the Riverfront Streetcar Line was opened along sections of the river in an area with many amenities catering to tourists. This was the first new streetcar route to be unveiled in New Orleans in 62 years. The line runs for 2 miles from Thalia Street at the upper end of the Convention Center to the downriver end of the French Quarter at the foot of Esplanade Avenue. It is August 15th. On this date in 2012, the St. Bernard Market at 1522 St. Bernard Avenue, also known as the Circle Market, was listed on the National Historic Register. It is August 16th. On this date in 1972, Wishbone Ash performed at the Warehouse at 8 p.m. Ticket prices were $3. It was a Beaver production that also presented Emerson, Lake, and Palmer on the same night at 9 p.m. General admission tickets were $5. It is August 17th. On this date in 1779, a hurricane made landfall at New Orleans. At the time, Spain had declared war on Great Britain. Almost all of Bernardo de Galvez's ships, the governor of New Orleans, that were to be used secretly to seize the British port of Baton Rouge were grounded or destroyed, thus ruining his plan for invasion on those days. We surely don't want to forget all those affected by the 1969 Hurricane Camille, as it hit on this date near the mouth of the river, causing $322 million in damage. It is August 18th. On this date in 1769, Alejandro O'Reilly arrived in New Orleans with 24 ships and 2,600 Spanish troops to take possession of Louisiana for Spain. O'Reilly was an Irish mercenary that had sworn allegiance to the Spanish crown. It is August 19th. On this date in 1960, former National Football League kicker and All-American at Michigan State University, Morten Andersen was born in Copenhagen, Denmark. Nicknamed the Great Dane, he's the all-time leading scorer in the NFL, as well as being the all-time leading scorer for two different rivaling teams, the New Orleans Saints, with whom he spent 13 seasons, and the, am I allowed to say their name? The Falcons, with whom he spent a combined 8 seasons. Andersen retired from football December 8, 2008. Easy life. It is August 20th. On this date in 1937, foundations are placed on the new concrete bridge at Robert E. Lee Boulevard across the Orleans Canal. This bridge replaced an old wooden structure and serves the lowest section of the Lake Vista subdivision. It was a very slow news day. It is August 21st. On this date in 1841, United States patent number 2223 was awarded to John Hampson, a manner of retaining in any desired position the slats of Venetian blinds. This adjustment design is still the most employed method in stringing Venetian blinds in use today. Hampson was not just an eccentric inventor, he was the mayor of Carrollton before it was annexed by the city of New Orleans. It is August 22nd. On this date in 1969, a project known as the Vieux-Carré Riverfront Expressway, a six-lane elevated highway along the river behind the French Quarter, was an ill-received plan by New Orleans, who fought to prevent its construction through the French Quarter. The voice of the people were heard, and the elevated expressway was never built. The freeway was removed from the interstate system on this date. However, one component of the original plan, a six-lane tunnel 690 feet long by 98 feet wide under the old Rivergate Convention Center, now Harrah's New Orleans Casino, was built and is presently used for valet parking.
Easy life.
It is August 23rd. On this date in 1996, born in New Orleans on September 27, 1926, Audrey Mickey Patterson passed away on this date. She grew up in Girtown and attended Daniil Elementary School and Gilbert Academy, where Jesse Owens visited and told her class, "There is a boy or a girl in this audience who will go on to the Olympics." She was 22 when she won her Olympic medal, covering the 200 meters in 25.2 seconds, winning her the bronze medal.
Easy life.
It is August 24th. Life goes on without Louis Prima, as he passed away on this date in 1978. Leon Prima was a trained pianist who became a trumpet player and a band leader. Prima composed Sing Sing Sing, now in the Grammy Hall of Fame, in 1936, before it became one of Benny Goodman's most popular swing-era tunes. 20 years later, Prima recorded Jump, Jive, and Wail. Other hits included Just a Gigolo, Buena Sera, Black Magic, and in 1967, he was the voice of King Louie the Orangutan in Walt Disney's animated film, The Jungle Book.
Life.
It is August 25th. On this date in 1984, Truman Capote died in Los Angeles. He was born in New Orleans on September 30th, 1924, and was most known for his novel In Cold Blood from 1965. It is August 26th. An ad on this date provided the schedule for the Camellia, a side-wheel steamboat which ran between Lake End, what we know as West End, and the North Shore. It carried U.S. mail daily between the cities of Mandeville, Lewisburg, Madisonville, Covington, and New Orleans. The elegant and very fast steamer carried people twice each week. On Sundays, the boat departed from West End at 7:30 a.m. and boarded for return at 7:30 p.m. The cost there and back was $1. Easy life. It is August 28th. On this date in 1990, Mayor Sidney J. Bartholomew, dressed in an old-time bathing suit, opens New Orleans' newest attraction, the Aquarium of the Americas. This photo op preceded his honor's actual descent into a shark tank to settle a bet with the aquarium director. Bartholomew had bet that Ron Foreman, director of the Audubon Institute, would not have the facility ready to open in time. Gotta be careful what bet you make. It is August 29th. On this date, all through history, you'll see many posts today discussing the 15th anniversary of the landfall of Hurricane Katrina. I will not get deep into this in this short format or attempt to give any insight to that trying day. I will take the time to wish my wife happy birthday, something that often gets overshadowed by other historical events. It is August 30th. On this date in 1956, measuring 23.86 miles in length at a cost of $30.7 million, the original span of the causeway opened. Cars lined up bumper to bumper on the Metairie terminus to take the first trip across the causeway on its opening day. The bridge was composed of 2,246 individual spans of concrete with two drawbridges for large passing vessels. It reduced the trip across the lake from approximately 53 miles to drive around to just 24. It is August 31st, 2020. In 1969, 2 weeks after Woodstock, on Labor Day weekend, Summer of Love music festivals were held throughout the United States and Canada. But New Orleans could travel just an hour away to their very own Love Inn, an event which was famously known and billed as the New Orleans Pop Festival. An estimated 30,000 young people trekked to the Louisiana International Speedway in Prairieville to see Janis Joplin, Canned Heat, and the Grateful Dead perform. Tickets ranged from $7 to $16 for a weekend pass. If you want to learn more about New Orleans, past or present, please visit our website at www.bigeasylife.org for our latest videos, blogs, and our merch store. And as always, thanks for being part of our Big Easy Life.